The beauty of Bakke Graduate University is the diversity of cultures, trades, and industry. For those of you that may not know, we have students, staff, and faculty literally from all over the world. Our professors and students range from business owners to executives in corporations, government officials, nonprofit, and church ministry. Together, we are advancing knowledge in innovative ways to change cities around the world. Would you bow your heads together with me for a word of prayer? May our time together be a reflection of your glory, O God. Refresh every participant that are here this day and those that are joining in from all parts of the world. And in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. We will begin today by receiving greetings from the executive leadership of BGU. And we have a very strong and diverse executive leadership team with extensive experience ranging across industries. And they have consistently used their wealth and influence to advance the mission of the university and continue to do so. Now, through their leadership, BGU is equipping leaders at all levels doing amazing things in some of the most vulnerable countries in the world. I'd like to thank you once again for coming and being here with us. Please join me to receive greetings from the executive leadership. We will begin with the Chairman, Board of Directors, Bakke Graduate University, Jack Von Hatzfeldt.
I am Jack Van Hartsfield, owner of Heartland Hotel Group. My calling is to empower teams to create lifestyle hotels, including our latest venture to remodel the historic Hotel Figueroa in downtown LA, as well as urban renovation projects in Tijuana, Mexico, the Rainier Valley of Seattle, and New Orleans after the Katrina hurricane. I've been on the board of Bakke since 2008. And currently am the chairman of the board. I want to wish you a Merry Christmas in whatever nation or time zone you're watching from. BGU has had an incredible year with leaders in over 60 nations as students. It is a unique family of people in business, urban ministry, government, churches, and education, all with common values and calling to impact cities for Christ. Thank you for your involvement in this amazing work. My hope is that this Christmas season is a time for seeing God's love for you in new ways as we celebrate God's gifts to us in the form of His Son, Jesus Christ.
Good morning, good afternoon, good evening for wherever you are in the world. We want to say thank you for joining us today and Merry Christmas as we approach this amazing season of joy, of thankfulness, and just understanding the gifts that God has given us. I am Brad Smith, the Chancellor of Bakke Graduate University. Our school has students, alumni, staff, as well as people we serve in over 100 countries in the world. And so Christmas is a special time of joy for us as you learn from each other how the Christmas story is told in so many different cultures and how that each of us learn God in new ways by hearing it from other cultures and other places. People often ask, why is Bakke Graduate University, which has been in this form about 20 years, already have students in so many countries? And a lot of that's how we were founded. We were founded on a network that Billy Graham established in his travels in the 50s and 60s. He noticed as he was traveling that a lot of the people that he met were doing amazing things for God. And yet nobody had heard of them in the West. And so he assembled a conference in Berlin in 1966. People were amazed at who he brought there. And then he established a more formal conference in 1974 in Lausanne, Switzerland. And out of that became what's called the Lausanne Movement. And that is the group that founded us. So by the early 2000s, the Lausanne Movement wanted somebody to help train these leaders that they had established and met through the different conferences and events over the years. And so we were asked to help do that. We did a surveys and focus groups and found out they did not want a seminary, but instead they wanted some type of a school that would help them understand the massive migration of populations in the world to cities and how that affected theology and practice of the church. They also said that the world is changing and it is so important now to understand how God is using business and business people as missionaries in new ways that we've never seen before. And there seems to be a divide between the church gathered and the church scattered, and to train pastors on how to equip people in the marketplace, as well as people in the marketplace to understand their role as the church in the business world and community and government, media, entertainment, education, other places in the world. And so we were founded with a school of Christian theology that drives us, a school of urban studies, and then a school of business. And this event this morning is being sponsored by the Business College of BGU and led by Scholastica Olangunju. And so we're appreciative of that and her leadership. And it's a way for us just to enjoy the season by hearing how God brings together a world of people understanding his grace demonstrated through the birth of his son. In that conference in 1974, one of the speakers remarked that Jesus was a Middle Eastern baby born in Asia that became an African refugee. Ray Bakke was the Lausanne Urban Associates and took that statement and did a talk called The Grandmothers of Christmas. There's a variety of versions of that. If you want to Google that, just say Ray Bakke, Grandmothers of Christian. You'll be blessed understanding how Ray articulated how Jesus was born with the blood of the nations and then shed that blood for the nations. And that this is a story not about just one part of the world, but it's a story about the whole world and how all of us have been blessed by the birth of Jesus Christ. So I'd like to read part of the Christmas story out of a short passage in Luke chapter 2. In those days, a decree went out from Caesar Augustus to all the world to be registered. This was the first registration where Quintius was governor of Syria, and all went to be registered, each to his own town. And Joseph went up from Galilee, from the town of Nazareth to Judea, so the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was the house and the lineage of David, to be registered with Mary, his betrothed, who was with child. And while they were there, the time came for her to give birth. And she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in a swaddling cloth and laid him in a manger because there is no place for them in the inn. I want to say thank you for joining us this morning. Many of you have given us year-end gifts to help BGU continue to serve those around the world. We want to say thank you for that. I'm excited to be part of this today and appreciate you being here as well.
In Alaska on the Kenai Peninsula, but I just happened to be south of Atlanta, Georgia in the United States today. And I want to read you from Matthew's Gospel, chapter 1, verses 21 through 23. She will give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins. All this took place to fulfill what the Lord had said through the prophet. The virgin will conceive and give birth to a son, and they will call him Emmanuel, which means God with us. Have a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Well, hello, BGU family. This is Brian McKay, president of Bakke Graduate University. I am so excited about what is happening at BGU and the amazing work that is happening in training up leaders in different parts of the world. Just wanted to highlight a couple of things from this past year. Our city immersion courses especially have just been life-changing experiences for so many people who have participated in those. It was in July, end of June into July, we had our Tegucigalpa, Honduras Urban Immersion. We had lots of different types of students who attended that from different programs, some as an education experience, some as doctoral programs, some as master programs. That was a full 10 days of a place that is very close to my heart. I've been to Honduras probably 6 or 7 times for different city immersion things and mission trips. Just a beautiful thing of what God is doing in that place. So it was nice to see a group from my church, actually, where I serve as a pastor in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. They met up with a group from BGU, and we combined forces for much of the city immersion there. We got to see leaders in business, in finance, in nonprofit, in consulting, in local churches. Ministries doing amazing work with serving people on the margins of Honduras and also places that are reaching people and powerful places in Honduras. So the students came away with a great snapshot of leadership, and they're applying what they're learning to their local context when they go back home. We were also in Phoenix, Arizona for a city immersion just a few weeks ago. I returned and I got to spend some time with the group there, another great group from different programs and people there to learn and grow from what they saw through Kit Danley's leadership with neighborhood ministries. They did a visit to the border to study migration issues. They studied Native American or indigenous culture and leaders who are operating amongst that people group. They got to see where God was at work amongst the margins and also in powerful places. We met with real estate developers, business leaders, leaders who are teaching theology of work for BGU and how to bring about transformation through amazing work principles and business principles. That's what BGU is all about, reaching people who are in powerful places and powerless places, equipping transformational leaders to make a difference with their lives, with their work. And I am excited to be involved with helping to lead that. I'm thankful for the work that's happening in our EMBA program. Hello to all of our EMBA students and professors and to our leaders. I think you're just doing a great job and that program is growing. You're building community with each other. And I'm excited about all of our BGU programs, honestly. We have some great certificates that are developing and students in different parts of the world, more than 65 countries, who are making a difference with their research, with their training that they're getting in their environments. So thank you to all of our faculty and our students and everyone who's involved with moving things forward at BGU. I want to say Merry Christmas to you and a Happy New Year. I'm excited about what God is doing, and I cannot wait for 2024. We are growing. We have the most number of students that we've had in classes just in this term that we're currently in now, the October term, and I'm looking forward to more growth in 2024. So hope you'll join me. Again, Merry Christmas and Happy New Year, and I look forward to seeing you all soon.
Welcome to this BGU Virtual Symphony of Sounds. I'm Willie Kachuga, Chair of the Board of Regents, and I have been part of BGU since 2010. BGU is at the forefront of innovative education, where we tailor courses to meet the diverse needs of our students and faculty worldwide. BGU Regents bring experience from various countries to shape courses to reflect a global perspective. Choosing BGU for your MBA is the first step on your journey to a satisfying significance. In my 40-year career in strategic planning and advising governments and collaborating with international funding institutions, I've seen the transformative power of turning success into lasting significance. Having directed complex multi-stakeholder projects and trained senior officials from over 25 countries, I understand the importance of going beyond mere success to achieve significance in one's career. BGU's EMBA program empowers students with both the knowledge and the practical experience required to become transformative change agents. We go beyond conventional education. We focus on cultivating leaders who don't just succeed, but leave a lasting impact. Significance is important. During an executive management course I taught at McGill University's Institute for Studies in International Development, I observed that a third of the class invested thousands of dollars from their own funds to uncover the so-called secrets of transcending success to achieve significance. Choose BGU for your EMBA, and you will gain more than just an education. You will develop tools to make a meaningful difference in your career and beyond. I invite you to join us on a path where success naturally evolves into significance and where your journey toward flourishing truly begins. I wish you all a meaningful Christmas and God's richest blessing for the new year.
Well said, Dr. Kutiga. I could not have put it better. You have captured the unique value of BGU and the Executive MBA School of Business. Equipping students to go beyond success, to influence and create a lasting impact is indeed our goal. Thank you, BGU Executive Leadership, for your greetings. We indeed feel welcome, and we will take your advice to enjoy ourselves today. Well, moving on, one of the keys to creating lasting impact for our students are our professors. Yes, BGU professors come from all over the world with training and expertise in the professions, technology, business, arts, education, name it, and extensive experience ranging from public to private sector, nonprofits, church, and parachurch ministries, even government. BGU professors bring years of practical, real-world experience from around the world into the classroom. Now, transformational results require transformational experience. The unique value is clearly demonstrated in BGU Executive MBA program, and our students enjoy it. Imagine when a student comes to class, they travel the world by reason of the continents represented in the room. Sit back as we receive greetings from a few of our professors around the world.
Dear BGU family, I'm Joel Soleil, an adjunct professor of the Executive MBA course. It is a privilege to send you my best wishes from Europe and from my home country, Hungary. I would like to wish you and your family a joyful and wonderful Christmas time and a fruitful new year for 2024. Hungary is a small country in the middle of Europe and on the crossroads of historic events and nations. Since 1000 after Christ, Hungary could keep its Christian heritage in spite of all the attacks on it, including the Ottoman occupation in the 16th century and the communist regime in the 20th century. I would also like to share the thought of Tomasz Sedlacek, a key economic thinker of our age, whose book titled The Economics of Good and Evil is an integral part of my course. All of economics is in the end economics of good and evil. It is a telling of stories by people, of people to people. Even the most sophisticated mathematical model is de facto a story, a parable, our effort to grasp the world around us.
Merry Christmas from the Executive MBA program of Backe Graduate University. I'm Dr. Les Hurst, and I teach change management in our program. We live in a world of constant accelerating change, We need Christian leaders who can shepherd people through the change and help them cope with uncertainty. One of our tasks is to raise up these kind of global leaders with the heart and skills to lead through these challenging days. Leaders that can bring hope to a world that is filled with despair. We pray this Christmas that Christ, the hope of the world, and the one who we are celebrating at this Christmas, will fill your heart with hope and joy. God bless you, and may this time together with us today be a blessing to you and to your family.
Hello, everyone. My name is Jeng Huan. I am a member of the EMBA Advisory Council. I'd like to share with you Isaiah 9:6. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government will be upon his shoulder, and he will be called Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Merry Christmas and Happy New Year to everyone. Maligayang Pasko at manigong bagong taon sa iyo.
Greetings from France, bonjour de la France, from a small village in the middle of the mountains and experiencing winter. The end of the calendar year is here, but I want especially to greet now the EMBA program and its director, Dr. Scholastica Olagunju, whom I appreciate deeply. And I've seen firsthand the impact of this EMBA program on my own son, who graduated last year with this BGU EMBA. His work life has changed drastically. He has learned how to integrate his faith in his work, and he got a promotion after his EMBA, getting his master's degree, and he's really enjoying his work and having a huge impact on his company. And as the BGU Academic Dean and PhD Program Director, I cannot but encourage you to look into applying to take and study again with Baki Graduate University, or support a student at Baki Graduate University, or contribute to the BGU community as much as you can. We have one goal and one mission, is to empower each leader throughout the world through studying and providing them support in their leadership. Baki Graduate University is your university. Be blessed. Joyeux Noël. Happy Christmas. Bonne année avec le Seigneur. Happy New Year with the Lord. And thank you to Dr. Scholastica for all her leadership in this program. Blessings.
Hi, I'm Dr. Dotun Reju, BGU Vice President for Africa. I want to tell you a little bit about myself. I trained in BGU and I graduated in 2012 in Transformational Leadership for the Global City. I'm an African. I'm very passionate about Africa because I believe God has a great plan for Africa. And BGU can be of great help in that particular area. Africa needs leadership. Africa needs that kind of leadership that can provide good governance. And to be able to provide good governance, we need good training. Training good in our own kind of situation will be training that is very, very contextual, that speaks our language, that addresses our unique realities. I really believe that Africa doesn't have a special problem. We just have a problem that requires a unique solution. And BGU gives you that, explains ourselves to us as the only ones who can really solve our problems.
Good morning, it's Matthew Mbunga. It's about 7:30 in the morning here in Zimbabwe. We're running a school camp with about 17-year-olds spread out all over the field doing different activities. We're doing a transformational leadership camp, inspiring these young people to take a leadership role in their own lives. They are learning during these 3 days that we're out here that there will be 1.5 billion children born on the continent of Africa in the next 30 years. That means by the time that these 17-year-olds are my age, or just older than I am now, they will have a massive youthquake to deal with. 1.5 billion hungry, uneducated Zimbabweans or Africans here on the continent of Africa, in a continent that already can't feed itself, a continent that already doesn't have enough schools to educate the current population. BGU equipped me to be a transformational leader, to come back to my own country, Zimbabwe, and to be part of the journey, part of the journey of equipping a generation of transformational leaders that can take a leadership role in their own lives and transform not only a country, but a continent, and lead to supply the answers, to be collaborative, to be compassionate, to be courageous, to be creative, and to solve the challenge that 1.5 billion children born on the hungriest, poorest continent on the planet will bring in the next 30 years. Shout out to BGU, to the incredible opportunity that I've had. And what I love doing is I teach one of the courses for BGU and have the privilege of remaining part of that network, that global community that has taught me so much, given me so much, and equipped me to return here to Zimbabwe and be part of the solution to the challenges that we face as a nation and as individuals. I want to encourage every one of you that is on your journey to believe big dreams, to work hard, and in the end you will win the game of life. And you hopefully will be able to equip and inspire people with the story and the knowledge and the faith in Jesus Christ that will unlock their potential, that will unlock the challenges that we face in the world today. I want to wish you all a Merry Christmas. It's summer here in Zimbabwe. I don't know if you're in a cold part of the world or a warm part of the world here in the Southern Hemisphere. Wherever you are, I pray that you are warmed by the love of Christ and that you offer the love and the warmth and the fellowship of the family of Jesus Christ to all that you encounter over this holiday season. God bless you. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Awesome. From every nation, tribe, and tongue, indeed we raise a sound. What a beautiful representation of the kingdom of God. That's the, you know, diversity that I love and I cherish about Bakke Graduate University. Indeed, we raise a sound. Well, moving on. America's got talent. Britain's got talent. Well, you know the show. Well, did you know BGU's got talent? Well, more from our professors from around the world. Take a look.
Hi, I'm Larry Peabody. Christmas and New Year's greetings from here in Lacey, Washington, about an hour south of Seattle. I received my DMin from BGU in 2012, and then for the next 8 years, I taught theology of work for the same school. Some of you may have seen some of my animated videos that I've recently been creating. These explain Kingdom of God reasons for doing our daily work. Let me take a moment to explain the why behind this series. Borrowing a page from Martin Luther King Jr., I have a dream. I dream of the day when working Christians everywhere are prepared for and see themselves as serving Jesus and his kingdom in their daily work. Sadly, in the U.S., here where I live, far too many enter their life's work without any biblical vision of it. And as a result, they make up some version of the American dream, seeing work as a way to make money or to gain status. What a loss for the kingdom of God and for the mission of the church. In this series of videos, I present more than a dozen kingdom of God motivations to get up and go to work. Here's a brief clip from the video, Work and Rest. No, Beethoven did not begin his Fifth Symphony that way. Ah, that little pause made things much better. Music takes more than just playing notes. Good music also includes rests, those breaks or silences between notes. If you are a guitarist and you see this sign in your musical score, you know you are to pause for 1/16th of a beat. Or, if you are on the French horn, this sign tells you to stop for the length of a quarter note. To any musician, a musical note says go, but a rest sign says stop. Pause here and rest for a bit. Those who compose music write into their scores not only notes for sounds, but also rests for silences. The effective combination of notes and rests can produce breathtaking music. God, the grand composer of everything, also built the rest stop right into his creation. By the seventh day, God had finished the work he had been doing, the creation music he had been playing. So on the seventh day, he rested from all his work. He ceased from his work of creation. Of course, he continues to work in other ways. So in composing creation, God wrote it with a seven-beat measure. Work, 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 rest. This means creation carries within its own history this work-rest rhythm. God's own work-rest rhythm set the pace for those made in his image. He spelled that out in the fourth of the Ten Commandments. 6 days you shall labor and do all your work, but the seventh day is a Sabbath to the Lord your God. On it you shall not do any work. So the musical score for our work includes that rest sign. All of these videos correspond to one or more chapters in my 2022 book, God Loves Your Work, Discover Why He Sends You to Do What You Do. I'm grateful for how my own time as a BGU student sharpened my vision for how our daily work fits into the purposes of God's kingdom. And my dream? Well, the EMBA program offered by the Bakke Graduate University is helping that dream come true. It equips students with the insights and skills they need in all kinds of work roles, in business leadership, and in ministry. And I encourage you to check it out for yourself. Merry Christmas and Happy New Year to the EMB program team, to the entire BGU family, and to its partners and friends.
Greetings to the EMBA program and the people who are maybe interested. Our EMBA program is very, very unique. And as registrar, it's been my privilege to encounter many people, many professors who have just been awesome. I am an artist. I put it aside. 20 years ago, I took a class with Dr. Ray Bakke in China, and I've been a BGU fan ever since. It's just a few of my artwork. This one I call the Screaming Cheetah. It's a scratch board. So you have a piece of white gessoed board, and then they spray black ink on it, and then I just scratch through. This one is a pencil sketch of a little Biafran baby. This one is called a stipple. This isn't the full picture, but this just gives you an idea. Every single thing is a little dot. That's what makes the picture. And this is the kitty cat, another scratch board. When I finished college, I became a stewardess. And in that process, I met and married my husband, Herb, and we traveled the second chapter of Acts, a Christian band. And that's me back in 1976. We did a tour with Jimmy Owens, and this is Pat Boone, and this was some of the senators. This was at the White House. We did a concert on the White House lawn. And so anyway, that's just a little bit about myself. I just wanted to say Merry Christmas and Happy New Year to you all. And be blessed. Have a wonderful, wonderful new year.
Hello, my BGU family. It is a joy to share with you and Dr. Scholastica with our innovative EMBA program and carry you greetings from the Caribbean, where Christmas is in the air, with wonderful, wonderful sceneries on land and at sea. I am Yvonne McKenzie, the director of your Master of Arts in Transformational Leadership here at BGU. And I am here just to share with you a poem I wrote in 2021. If only I had figured it was his story, I would have smiled where I cried, starved the anxiety, fanned the weak embers of hope, and danced. So I erased the script that bore the lies. Come with me. The message of unending love that teaches through the pain, restores and strengthens again and again. Beauty for ashes, no despair. Let's dance. Have yourselves a wonderful, beautiful, Christ-centered holiday and dance.
I wish. I would like to continue that. Maybe some. Well, in our executive MBA program at BGU, moving on, purpose matters. And no one captures it better than Dennis Bakke. Dennis' life and career, for those of us that do not know him, through his various businesses, notably AES Corporation, an electricity company, and Imagine Schools, a nonprofit charter school network, both of which Dennis Bakke co-founded. These institutions model purpose, success, and influence. Under Dennis's leadership as president and CEO from 1994 to 2002, he used these principles, purpose really matters, for AES, and AES grew to a global power company with 27,000 employees in 27 countries. You will hear a recurring theme of purpose, passion, and good business run through our students' testimonies, regardless of age, gender, ethnicity, professional background, or industry. BGU has students, like we already know, in over 65 nations. And our EMBA students are part of that number. Well, join me as we receive greetings and testimonies from a few of our students doing amazing things around the world. But first, a clip from Dennis Bakke. Enjoy.
Purpose of business?
Foster commerce.
Foster commerce, okay. Any others?
Provide a return to shareholders.
Yeah, make money for shareholders, okay.
Provide a service or product.
Provide a service or product. You know, people looking for work think the purpose of business is what?
Create jobs.
Create jobs. A lot of politicians the same way. What's the other thing that the politicians really think about? What's the big thing that they think about purpose of business? Huh?
Taxes.
Yeah, tax revenue. You see, there's a huge number of possibilities. Today on Wall Street, the purpose of business is clearly to make a profit. For a lot of people who work inside the business, the purpose is to make money for themselves. And we have all these other possibilities. But I would suggest to you that the purpose of business is not primarily to make a profit. We have very much mixed up the idea of the means and the ends. The purpose of business is to do a service, to meet a need, to do something wonderful for the world. Along the way, helping out people inside. But the purpose, the absolute primary purpose of the business is to steward resources, take care of the You know, we've been given brain power and money, capital, resources, and materials in order to make something wonderful happen in the world. It's a trust. It's incorporated. We are citizens of society, given special privileges in society. We are incorporated. Behind every single incorporation document, has anyone ever filled out an incorporation document? There's a little line there that says what? Purpose. Purpose. And the purpose, I bet every business puts in there, is not to make a profit. You'd never know that in the world. I'm suggesting that the purpose of business is to steward resources to meet a need in society and to do it in an economically sustainable manner. Shareholders don't get maximum, but they have to get enough that's fair and just for what they put in. And there is nothing negative about profits. They are absolutely essential. Maximizing is a different story, because maximizing infers that other people are going to take less than they deserve in order to get this. And I don't buy that concept. Does it matter what your purpose is? If you believe that the purpose of business is to create good jobs, you will operate differently.
Hi, my name is Katie Burry. I am the Director of Student Services here at BGU, and I'm also currently a student in the DTL program. In addition to my work at BGU, I run a ministry in Antigua, Guatemala called Abeja Flowers. We're a social business partnering with women in our community to provide dignified, safe employment. Everything about what we do is holistic. In addition to sustainable economic opportunities, we offer weekly therapy sessions, Bible study and discipleship classes, and weekly prayer meetings where we can really intercede for our community. I'll let Lesbia, who leads our program, share a little more about what we do, because it is way more fun to hear from her.
La verdad que en Guatemala es muy difícil encontrar un trabajo si uno tiene más de 30 años. Son muy pocas las posibilidades. Pero ese es nuestro lema en Abeja, dar un trabajo digno y seguro a muchas mujeres donde van a crecer y descubrir sus habilidades para apoyar a sus familias económicamente. Cada producto que creamos en Abeja va lleno del brillo de Guatemala. Usamos plantas que crecen en la naturaleza para dar un look y un estilo que no existe con la competencia. Eso nos hace diferentes. También producimos nuestras flores únicas que no hay en el mercado para dar a nuestros clientes un producto único. Cada ramo, cada arreglo, cada boda que decoramos está lleno de mucha paz y amor. Para nosotros el trabajo con las flores es una forma de bendecir nuestro país y nuestra comunidad también, con un trabajo lindo y con productos que proporcionan mucha alegría y paz.
Our program was directly birthed because of my studies at BGU. It was through really understanding the transformational leadership principles that I was challenged to take a step back, humbly ask questions, and analyze together with women in the community from their cultural perspective what was the need, what they wanted, and then develop together a sustainable solution. The women who started as a part of our project are now literally acting as transformational leaders within their communities. They are running an expanding business where they are creating opportunities to hire more and more women. They also are acting as advocates by expanding the holistic support services we offer based on needs they see within their community. We are now 3 years into our ministry/social business, and the adaptation and growth continues. I recently took the ASM 701 Organizational Assessment course that is offered in the business school with Dr. Scholastica, director of the EMBA program, and it proved to be so vital in terms of providing a literal toolbox of strategies to take and use as we make plans for adaptation and growth moving forward. The course added so much value to our work as we continue to level up and expand both from a ministry and business perspective. Thank you so much for allowing me the time to share about the exciting things happening here in Guatemala and at BGU. From Guatemala, I'm wishing the BGU School of Business a Merry Christmas and Happy New Year, filled with light and hope. Feliz Navidad y Feliz Año Nuevo.
Hola, mi nombre es Carolina Mesa Clark. I am original from Colombia, South America. I've been living in the U.S. for the last 14 years. 3 years ago, I started my journey with Baki Graduate University. I enrolled the program, the EMBA. What an amazing time and great opportunity that I had to learn from professors that had such a wisdom and understanding to bring that kingdom of God on this earth. Also, I had the privilege to sit down with my classmates where they were walking that talk and building also the shalom of the city. The EMBA program is helping me to go and walk with the people and creating programs that are focusing on human being, cultivating the human being in the center of the economy. So economic mutuality is a very important concept for me. How we invest in people, planet, profit, and how can we, through that investment, bring a cultivation and transformation in places. Now, with the experience of 10 years, and also with Baki Graduate School behind me and all the information that during these 3 years now, I got the opportunity to go back and give back to my own country. The same experience, the poverty that I live and my mom and my grandma also live, now I can bring solutions. I am reflecting today how God has been so good. I love in a passage in Jonah, when he was asking and talking to God, and he said, I knew from the very beginning that you were a merciful God, a God that loved to do mercy to foreigners. You know, I'm sitting down and I'm writing my cast on, and I am looking to how can people see that God of mercy? How can we rebuild those communities if it's not for transformation in their well-being? As my cast on is to create a business called CND, a community and development. CND is that bridge. CND is the vehicle that we are using to bring the products from women in other countries, especially right now in my country, Colombia, to bring into the market. We have three connections with small businesses that they are doing good to planet people. And they also creating that transformation, creating sustainability and profitability for them. Thank you, Baki family. Thank you so much for doing this. Thank you for supporting me, for investing so much in my life for these last 3 years. Your information and all the experience allow me to put in practice many of the information and the knowledge that I receive in the classrooms. Thank you so much for believing and investing not just in me to transform my community, but also in the many leaders around the world that they are doing it a great job to bring in that shalom of God in this world. And from my family to yours, Feliz Navidad y Prospero Año Nuevo.
Hi everybody, I'm Paula Togni from Rio Grande do Sul, south of Brazil. I am a EMBA Advisory Council member, and I want to read verses of the Bible with you. Luke 2:11-14 says, today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a babe wrapped in clothes and lying in a manger. Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with angel, praising God and saying, glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests. May the peace of the Lord be with you and your family in this season. Feliz Natal y Feliz Ano Novo. Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Um novo dia, um novo tempo,
tempo de deixar nascer. Olhar pra dentro, ver esperança naquele que faz tudo florescer. É Natal, Deus Filho foi dado a nós. É Natal, Deus Pai um presente nos deu. É Natal, Emmanuel, Deus presente conosco está. É Natal. Um novo dia, um novo tempo, tempo de deixar nascer. Olhar pra dentro, ver esperança naquele que faz tudo florescer. É Natal, Deus Filho foi dado a nós. É Natal, Deus Pai um presente nos deu. É Natal, Emmanuel, Deus presente conosco está. É Natal, Deus Filho foi dado a nós. É Natal, Deus Pai um presente nos deu. É presente conosco está. É Natal, Deus Filho foi dado a nós. É Natal, Deus Pai um presente nos deu. É Natal, Emmanuel, Deus presente conosco está. É Natal, Deus Filho foi dado a nós. Deus Pai um presente nos deu. É Natal, Emmanuel, Deus presente conosco está. É Natal. É Natal.
My name is Cheryl Johnson, and I'm a student in the Master of Transformational Leadership program at BGU. And I'm also a pastor at Westview Bible Church in Montreal, Quebec, Canada. We're an English-speaking church in French Canada, and I oversee the discipleship and strategic planning for the church. So this means that I work hard to ensure that we're effectively building disciples at every age level and becoming the healthiest church that we can be. And that's actually a huge passion of mine, to not only ensure that the church I lead is actively pursuing health, but to help churches across Canada do the same. You know, my story with the church is marked by hurt and disillusionment, and I've heard many similar stories across North America. But by God's grace, my history with the church has also been one of healing and reconciliation. I love the church, and I know that it's how God chooses to bring his kingdom on earth. And so I want to be a pastor known for helping people who have similar stories to mine heal well. This past semester, I took the ASM 701 organizational assessment class offered in the business school with Dr. Scholastica, the director of the EMBA program. And I was hoping to understand how to use organizational assessment in my mission to help churches to be healthy places of healing. And I was not disappointed. The class provided me with many tools and new perspectives for being an agent of healing and change within the Canadian Church. I've been challenged to evaluate my own leadership differently, to press into equipping, leading, and empowering people better so that they can fulfill their specific gospel calls, and then examining whether there are better ways to do what we do. I'm not someone who settles for the status quo. And so this class has expanded my view on how to reject that and strive for more for God's glory. As Christmas approaches, I've been meditating on how Jesus came to redeem the world and how there is nothing beyond his redemptive reach. And that brings me comfort and hope as I serve him and live out this mission. And I trust it does for you as well. And so to the BGU Executive MBA program, I wish you a Merry Christmas, Joyeux Noël, and Happy New Year. Bonne année.
Hello everyone. Hi, my name is Michael Oglegwa. I live in Nigeria, Benue State. I'm a student of the EMBA program at BGU. I just want to use this opportunity to say Merry Christmas and a lovely, lovely New Year to come to all of you. I'm currently the Commissioner of Finance, Budget and Economic Planning in Benue State. So in my current role, I'm responsible for the economy of about 6 million people, of a state with 6 million people. It's an agrarian state. Lovely, lovely natural place to be. And from all of us in Benue State, Nigeria, Merry Christmas to you all. I want to say thank you especially to Dr. Scholastica, who's helped me through this process, and Dr. Dot. Between them, they've helped me to encourage me. Now I know I made the right decision to stick with this program. Now, the program has helped me to properly situate my role as a child of God, and at this job, I'm a steward of God's important resource, and I'm responsible for making sure that so many get a feel, a taste, a touch of God's intention, God's plan. And as a steward of resources, both material and human, I know that I'm just filling a gap for the real owner of the stuff, who is God. And I'm grateful for the experience. So once again, Merry Christmas and have a beautiful, beautiful day ahead. Thank you. Bye.
Season's greetings, everyone. I'm Sandra Hicks. I am the founder of Heartstone Network, and I've been a filmmaker for 40 years. I'm very pleased to be getting an EMBA from Bakke Graduate University. And part of the project that I'm working on that Bakke has had such an influence is a project called Garden for Life. This is a project I'm working on with another student of Bakke, and that's Fred Billings. We are creating a program to teach people around the world, specifically targeting developing nations, in how to grow food and how to grow food with regenerative farming practices. It's also a way to share the world, especially young people, so that they can see, like maybe if you live in Africa, you can see what life is like in Montana, or maybe in Vietnam, etc. And it's also a leadership program, and as with all of the programs we do, it's infused with the gospel. I was greatly influenced by a class I took with Matt Mabenga on ecology and sustainability. It really taught me, well, it actually gave me a real appreciation for this project we're doing, Garden for Life, when I really understood how necessary it was to have regenerative farming practices, and when I understood the importance of the soil. So this script actually for Garden Life has been greatly influenced by that class, and I'm currently in a class with Brad Smith on fundraising, which I find extremely helpful. So I'm very thankful for everything I'm learning at Bakke, and I'm very thankful to be a part of this whole online Bakke family. I know it's a group of people that are all setting out to change the part of the world that they've been called to change. And I think together, we can all make a big difference for the kingdom of God. So thank you for letting me share my story and for listening. And I do wish you all a very Merry Christmas and an awesome 2024.
Merry Christmas, everyone. My name is Fred Billings. I'm a businessman, an entrepreneur, and a student at Bakke Graduate University. I also have the privilege of being a participant on the EMBA Advisory Council. Our program director has asked me to share a little bit about some of the work that I'm doing. First, let me give some context. Like the little drummer boy, I really don't have any gifts that are fit to give a king. And any of the gifts that I do have, actually got from the king. So I'm really nothing but more than a fellow drummer boy trying to play my best for the one who loves me most, Jesus. My journey, like most business enterprises, has been fraught with successes and failures. I joined the EMBA program a few years ago to explore how to build a multi-generational legacy and growth into the most important enterprise in my life, my family. I like to think of the various businesses, profit and nonprofit, as subsidiaries to the family enterprise. After all, the family is God's design. Most of us have no intentional purpose or mission statement for our families. While the EMBA program is equipping me to meet this challenge, it has influenced all of the subsidiaries and shaped them for a better future. Buds and Blossoms, Inc. is a plant nursery and landscape design install business in Northwest Houston, Texas. I enjoy the privilege of owning and operating this business with my wife and sons. We serve our community as the enterprise serves as a base from which we are able to invest in a wide variety of synergistic endeavors. Garden for Life is an organic gardening and leadership development program designed to empower people anywhere in the world to grow their own food without dependence on chemical agriculture, building soil and souls as participants discover the invisible attributes of God in the garden. In collaboration with Foundations for Farming, who I met at BGU, we added row crops to the content and have started filming 60 plus training videos that will become a tool for agricultural and social development that heals both people and planet. Grow for Life is a for-profit company that collaborates and partners with a nonprofit Indian Commerce Campsite to work with Native Americans on the Flathead Indian Reservation in Northwest Montana. We're developing a plan and the leadership to create food security to diversify the agricultural economy for the 1.2 million acre reservation. Mission Ridge is a business and activity center we are just opening on the reservation to stimulate healthy community development on the reservation with Native and non-Native residents. In Uganda, in collaboration with Sandra Martin Hicks, also a BGU student and founder of the Heartstone Network, we're equipping South Sudanese refugees with agricultural training and resources to abate the starvation in these massive refugee camps. A Drop of Grace, A Father's Guide to Intimacy, is a book I'm just completing to restore healthy, intimate relationships to marriage and family. The promised and true Christmas gift from Jesus is life to the full. At age 62, I've come to understand that life is intimate relationships with family, friends, and above all else, with the creator and sustainer of the universe, Jesus Christ. Shall I play for him? Yes, I shall. Admittedly, some of us are noisy and bang our drums and with loud, irregular beats. Others strike the leather so softly it's barely heard. Baku Graduate University is giving me the understanding, tools, skill, and relationships to play my drum better, to strike in tone, volume, and rhythm so that I can play my best for him. Let's play our drums for him this season to the best of our ability. Our life to the full is our drum. It is part of the beat of his presence on the earth. Play for him. Play for your family. Play for your community. And play for the whole world if given the opportunity. I really doubt that the young mother of Jesus knew when she kissed her little baby that she was kissing the face of God. We can only prepare, be faithful, and live humbly with the question, did you know? Merry Christmas. From one drummer boy to another. Play.
Merry Christmas, indeed. Well said, Fred. We will play our drums for him. It's just amazing how BGU students from different cultures, ages, and industries play the drums of life and a business to make a symphony of sounds in the orchestra of life. Well, BGU School of Business would like to help you play your drums even better. You can be part of a global network doing amazing things, creating a symphony of sounds around the world. Well, thank you for hanging in with us. A couple of more to go, and we are almost at the end of this event. Hang in there because great things are yet in store. Good business is influence that lifts people out of poverty. It restores wasted places and creates wholeness. This sounds to me like the Christmas story, the birth of a savior to bring hope and redemption to lost and broken people. Ray Barkay is one whose mission emphasizes a theology as big as the city. It is befitting as we celebrate Christmas to remember Christ, the reason for the season. Let's share this short clip. Take a look.
Years ago, a couple hundred years ago, actually, Ben Franklin, an American philosopher, the time of the Revolution, George Washington, contemporary, he wrote many wise and outrageous things, one of which I like very much. If you want to guarantee success, choose with great care your grandfather. Way to go, Ben. How do you do that? Only one person had that option. Jesus had eternity to choreograph an entrance. I think Matthew is reminding us that Jesus choreographed into his own family tree without violating anybody's humanity or willpower all of the scandals, racial groups from the Middle East. And by the way, if you study the genealogy, as scholars have, you'll also learn that up and through the time of David, Mary and Joseph, 1,000 years later, had the same DNA, the same genealogy. After David, the line split, and Joseph's line goes one way and Mary's goes the other. So the virgin birth would only work for one of them, Mary, not Joseph. But because Joseph had the same DNA, here's what I said to my son Brian one day. Brian, Jesus chose his ancestry. I told him these stories. I said, this one's for you, Brian. Jesus not only got his blood from the world, he shed that blood on the cross for the world. The blood of Canaanites, Moabites, Hittites, and Jews flowed together and flowed from that cross. This smashes racism, classism, ethnocentrism in the opening paragraph. This list of names is part of Matthew's mission statement. Not only that line I love in another gospel, he came unto his own. This is who his own are, Canaanites, Moabite, Hittite, Jew. Everybody in the city qualifies here. This cemetery tour is for us. The five parts of Matthew's Christmas story, the cemetery tour, which brings all that choreography of mixed racial, sinful people into the bloodline. The virgin birth, which reminds us of the purity and holiness, God taking that risk. Nothing could be more anti-Gnostic than that the sinless God would connect with this body, which had bloodlines coming from all these people. But that's what the gospel is. Jesus is willing to live in us. We become an earthly vessel for the living God. We don't go to church. We are church. We are indwelt. You see, God is still doing that, still connecting with sinful people like you and me. And then the coming of the worship team from the Arab world, I think, a promise yet unfulfilled. Arabs are not spoken of well in the news these days. The media has not been kind to the Arab world. Most of the Christians, I'm sure you know this, most of the Christians in the Middle East are Arabs. Running institutions like Bethlehem Bible College, theological seminaries. There have been Arab Christians since Pentecost. In fact, if you look at Acts 2, you will see the last word on that list of all the people who were in the upper room, Arab. They were there. They've been there for 2,000 years. They suffer all the time. Now the Syrian Orthodox and the Syrian others are suffering. So these stories linger. The Arab church is suffering. The wise men who brought gifts to Jesus are coming from that world to worship him way back then, and they're still coming. I know many of them, and they love Jesus dearly. And then you have the Egyptians receiving Jesus, reminding us again that God loves Egypt, visited it, promised that an altar would always exist in Egypt. Read Isaiah about that. And then you have Rachel, the mother of lost kids. She's the saint of our time. Children dying. This is the story, and it ends in hope. Jesus is coming back. The exile has come back. He's coming back again, you know. We don't know when, but that's the hope we have, and the Christmas story is about that. I hope that this story takes on new meaning for you, maybe a new way to talk to some of your neighbors who are caught up in some of these tragedies as well. To God be the glory, and to the earth be peace.
Greeting. I am a member of the EMBA Advisory Council. I live in Bentonville, Arkansas, here in the United States. I wanted to share with you a message from John 1, 1 through 2, as well as verse 14 from the message. It says, "The Word was first, the Word present to God, God present to the Word. The Word was God in readiness for God from day one." And then verse 14 says, "The Word became flesh and blood and moved into the neighborhood." I love that because something Richard Rohr once said was, "We Franciscans have always believed that the incarnation was already the redemption, because in Jesus' birth, God was already saying that it was good to be human and God was on our side." As we enter in the Christmas season, I just want us all to remember that it's good to be you. God is on your side. Enjoy that. Soak it in. Hope you have a safe and wonderful Christmas, New Year, and happy holidays.
Well, Jesus, the Prince of Peace, encourages us, "Peace be still." And as we see in John 16:33, "I have told you these things so that in me you may have peace. In this world you will have trouble, but take heart. I have overcome the world." Well, our confidence today as we celebrate Christmas is that God is faithful and he will not fail. So we have a firm foundation, Christ the rock on which we stand. Ray Barkey reminds us that Christ is coming back again. He will be revealed and all flesh will see him. I invite you to think on these things. If you do not know Christ, you can ask him to come into your heart and he will reveal himself to you. And Romans 10, 9 and 10 says it well. If you declare with your mouth Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. For it is with your heart that you believe and are justified, and it is with your mouth that you profess your faith and are saved. He will forgive and wash you clean if you ask him to. We are not a church, obviously. However, you can reach out to us with the information on the screen. We will have there at the end of the program, and we can guide you to a local church where you can learn more and grow in your faith in God. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I like to thank BGU Board of Directors, and I especially appreciate the chairman of the board, Jack Van Hatzfeld. Thank you for all you do. Your heart and your giving is making a difference through the work of students around the world. Thank you, BGU Chancellor, Dr. Brad Smith, for your support and tireless commitment to expand the frontiers of the university. I thank you, BGU President, Dr. Brian McCabe, for your leadership. You are taking the university to new heights. I'd like to thank the members of the Executive MBA Advisory Council. So thank you for your support and good work. A big thank you to all our program directors, our professors, highly esteemed faculty and staff joining us from around the world today. Thank you for all you do. A very big thank you to all our contributors for sharing your gifts and talents with us. May the Lord richly bless you. A very big thank you to our students and alumni. Give it up for them joining us from around the world. Thank you for the great work you are doing. May God richly bless you as well. And I want to say a very special thank you to the technical team that worked with me to make this production successful. Please a shout out to Zuza, Christina, and Natalia. Thank you so much. I am very appreciative. I have left the best for the last that you turned up today. You have been an amazing audience. The program would not be half as successful without your presence. Thank you so much. I want to especially thank my husband, Jide Olagunju. He's a professor here at the Conflict Studies Program. Thank you for bearing with me all the long nights. Thank you so much. Please do not forget to drop your email address in the chat box if you would like more information about our Executive MBA program or other programs offered at Bakke Graduate University. We would like to connect with you. Well, in addition to our EMBA program, which has a strong leadership focus, BGU School of Business offers ongoing empowerment webinars, networking opportunities, and certificate courses that can be customized to your unique needs. In addition to working with individuals like you, we partner with organizations, communities, churches, and groups around the world to build relevant and contextual professional development. Our information will be on the screen in a moment. Natalia, hold on just a couple of more seconds. You may connect with us at your convenience. We look forward to connecting with you. Well, this program, Symphony of Sounds, has been brought to you by Bakke Graduate University, obviously, the Executive MBA Program and School of Business. I am Dr. Scholastica Olagunju, Director of the Executive MBA Program. It has been my pleasure and privilege to be your host today. May we pray. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord be kind and gracious to you. May the Lord keep you with favor and give you peace. Well, Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year to all. You have been an amazing, amazing audience. Well, what do I say? See you next year. Merry Christmas. Please say Merry Christmas to someone in the chat. Would you go ahead and give us that sound? Merry, Merry, Merry Christmas.